Nintendo has been on fire this year, even though their sales haven't been the highest. But the game quality of each one of their titles this year has been A+ material from these titles, which makes me glad to have a Wii U this year. Now, here comes Captain's Toad Treasure Tracker, another one of these great titles. Playing as the hero with no jumping ability or fully fleshed out combat attacks is a new and fresh way to take on games this time around, and with the Mario 3D World spin on it, that makes it a joy to look at. Now, for the presentation, the world of Mario is easily one of the most recognizable franchises ever, dealing with the Mushroom Kingdom. Here, in Treasure Tracker, it uses the same engine as in 3D World. The world here is polished and clean, and the vibrant colors rule the land, and the scope is fully realized. But the thing here I really want to go deep in is the game's perspective itself. Here's what I think is the most important aspect of the game. When you play Treasure Tracker, every stage and level is displayed in a subspace zone with a camera that has, well, free reign. The thing I hated about other puzzle platformers was the camera choices, and when in those camera choices, traveling from room to room just to activate a small part of the puzzle, which was unnecessary. But in this game, you see the puzzle as a whole, which I think is the best way to solve a puzzle. Seeing it as a whole and figuring out the increments and what makes it tick. Seeing the scale, design, and depth of each stage, and finding each star in every unique way makes this a great sight to see. Now switching to gameplay. Now we've probably heard this in every single reviewer of Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker, that this game isn't your average Mario game. Well, it isn't. Captain Toad can't jump, flip, or fly in this game, and he walks and traverses the stages in a steady pace to explore and find each treasure hidden in every crevice of every level. Now Nintendo here delivers the goods, and it may seem like a given, but for this genre and for this character, first time ever having his own main game, it's a good surprise, and it runs on a smooth 60 frames per second. Given that Treasure Tracker is even more refined than Super Mario 3D World, the engine never really misses a beat in handling in a flawless performance. The gamepad is really good to use as you elevate pieces of the land or use the screen for the rail shooting bits, and also used for zooming in and other neat features. With things like 70 plus stages, rhythm-based platforming, in some cases, elevating and rotating stages, and cool enemy patterns to counter by timing, Treasure Tracker comes out to be an amazing and fun experience at a calming pace. So for the final verdict of Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker review, from S-class to fail, I'm giving the gameplay grade overall a solid A, with its great puzzle design, cute and fabulous characters and world atmosphere that we all know and love, and the key feature of the game is the subspace diorama stages that give us a nice perspective for our camera that really makes this game shine. Now the only problem I had with the camera overall was the gyro sensor in the gamepad, but since I'm a steady Wii U player, I didn't really have that much of a distraction. But just to warn you guys, don't move the controller that much. For the replay value, it's shockingly high. There's so much to do. Hidden treasure, more objectives to do, 70 stages, time trials, a secret ending, just a whole bunch of content in one game. But casuals might feel like this is a short game if they don't go all the way. And for the Consumer Report, buy it at full price. $40, it's been marked down to $40. It might seem much to, you know, a lot of people, but it's better than $60. And if you can get it at a decent price, like $30, that's even better. And this game is well worth a collect in your Wii U library. This is a great game for the holidays to play, and a well surprise for me, so I'm glad this game was a success. Well, that's it for today's video, but if you want to see more, go ahead and click on my main channel, AlterElement Games. There I have videos ranging from gameplay highlights, full video game reviews, music soundtracks from some of the best games, and gaming and news updates. Keep it live here at AlterElement Games, and visit my fan page on Facebook and Twitter. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and thank you for supporting my channel. Cafe Olé, peace and love, I'm outta here.
AlterElement Games, where gameplay is everything.